So I think most of the people who are almost all the people that the names I'm seeing, they are very regular with us. So I think I don't need to introduce you once again. All the people are regular. So you could possibly start the session. Over to you, Dr.
So last time we mentioned that they can ask some questions. I think one or two questions can take up, or in the meantime, in the waiting time, you can take up one or two questions and then we can start.
Does anyone have any questions? Because last time when Dr. Shashikant was presenting towards the end of his
I
workshop, there was some disturbance, I think, in the internet and people could not complete their questions. So if anybody has any questions, you can ask Dr. Shashikant now about the last session. And otherwise, we can go ahead. I think,
sure.
Doctor, there are no questions. So please carry on with today's program.
So one request is yes, sir. So I request you to mute from your side so that the voice will be a little comfortable for all the people so that they can really relax. Last session, relaxation module 1 and relaxation module 2, we have already shared. But this one, I'll add it in a such a way that you learn a little extra. So there are 6 modules for relaxation techniques anywhere in the world. Usually, people use this 6 type of module. And 2 of them, we are going to practice in combination. So one is autogenic training, second one is biorhythm training, third one is progressive muscular relaxation technique, fourth one is a breathing technique, this one is a meditation, this one is a visualization. So these are only 6 modules where all the people worldwide in any of the relaxation technique they use this. Anybody, any Guruji, Swamiji, father, whether whatever religion, whatever background, whatever Buddhist, whatever it is, they'll use only these six condensed modules. So sometimes if it is a religious, they'll say visualize and feel the God and all those. If it is a religious symbolism, they'll use the cross, om, all other symbolisms of spiritual religious symbolisms. So ultimately condensed way is it is all these 6 modules of relaxation techniques which can be extended. So when I mentioned this 6 module, it means that based on this 6 module, we can at least make 110 or 112 meditation techniques, 110 or 112 relaxation techniques. So this is a tremendous possibility of what each module of relaxation technique can do. So in that sense, with the basic medical knowledge what I have and with the present scenario of the stress, anxiety, hypervigilant state, what is happening right now is hypervigilant. And even hypervigilant in my case, I'll give you an example. I'm sitting in my clinic with the 3 masks wearing on, So that is a hypervigilant. So by any chance, I don't want to get affected by the virus. So in that sense, everybody, every one of us are hypervigilant. Hypervigilant means our body's sympathetic nervous system will overwork, and there are small glands here on the top of your kidney. We call it as the adrenal gland. These adrenal glands will keep secreting stress hormones and make your sympathetic nervous system active and hypervigilant in a way to protect your body, mind, spirit. In a way to protect this bio machine. So for this, somewhere there is a exhaustion. So this is sometimes we call it as adrenal exhaustion. That is actually a medical term, but more of the stress response is triggered and the sympathetic nervous system is activated. when the sympathetic nervous system is activated more, we have increased blood pressure, increased the blood glucose, increased the blood lactic acid levels. So tiredness of the body, muscles will get tired very fast, increased heart rate, increased respiratory rate, increased alertness, increased perspiration, increased sweating, and hyper-alert state. And this can lead to some symptoms like sleeplessness, very alert phase, moody mood swings, or anxiety or depression. It is only a state of mind where the sympathetic nervous system is overactive and the parasympathetic, the nervous system which will make our body relax, is less active. So with this statement of hypervigilant state and sympathetic and parasympathetic, what we trying to derive out of this is, if we practice some relaxation technique, even if it looks like a just visualization of your own body and telling your bone body that, okay, my arms are relaxed, my arms are getting heavier, all the muscles are getting relaxed, you're actually sending a signal to the deep down part of your subconscious mind. And with this signal, the body's nervous system will act in a such a way that it will stimulate the parasympathetic nervous system and it will set the relaxation response. So these medical words, I think later on I can share it with Rajesh sir, these words, where you can find out what I mean, and you'll be able to clearly understand that these relaxation techniques are definitely will be of great help. I'll reveal one or two statistical information previous, and now it might be much more. So National Institute of Health USA says that 70% of primary physician's visit, when somebody visits a doctor or the family doctor first time, 70% of the symptoms are related to stress. So sympathetic nervous system. So this is a staggering statistical data saying that 70% of all the problems like neck pain, back pain, acidity, sleeplessness, constipation, whatever indigestion it is, 70% of the cases it is related to stress. It means rather than giving medicine to all these 70% of the symptoms all the time, that's what it happens in a conventional medicine. What we offer is we give the medicine, no problem, because we are also conventional doctors. At the same time, we'll teach you some relaxation techniques or some breathing techniques or visualization technique where you can adopt with this and take the medicine. It will be much more beneficial than just, you know, popping the pill. In that sense, this will become much more, these relaxation techniques will become much more relevant. And when you really practice it like a habit, then you'll really get depth of relaxation. So when you are practicing relaxation, you use the two components. One is your intelligence, second one is your intuition. So let your mind and heart be open to receive any simple signals like my hand is getting relaxed. It looks very silly to say to ourselves that my hand is getting relaxed, but it's okay. Let us accept that and really focus our mind on that area of the body and try to make it relaxed and see, are we able to do it or are we not able to do it? In that sense, you accept this class as an open mind and open heart. Keep this mind and heart open. Use your intelligence and the intuition and your imagination. So let us use this three and practice this simple autogenic training. Okay, I'll start with this. So I'll not tell you what is autogenic training, what is biorhythm training right now. Let us practice first and then we'll feel it. I'll use four of the techniques together. So make it as a package and where you feel, you know, nothing different, but you'll feel it at your body and mind, you feel relaxed. Once you feel that, later on after the session, if we have some 10-15 minutes, we'll have a wonderful discussion. Okay. Get ready. Adjust yourself to a most comfortable sitting posture or lying down posture. You make yourself comfortable in whichever position you are in. Either sitting on the chair or lying down on the bed, no problem. Shift your awareness towards your breathing. Very gently close your eyes. The world which you are always seeing from your eyes and ears, all the five senses towards outside, we are just closing the eyes for some time to bring the mind towards inside. So with that idea, I request you to close your eyes. Closing your eyes, shift your awareness towards your breathing. Gentle breathing in and relaxed breathe out. Gentle breathing in and relaxed breathe out. Keep doing the same breathing in and breathing out for another 3 to 4 counts. Gently breathing in and breathe out. Gentle breathing in and breathe out. Gentle breathing in and breathe out. Keeping your eyes closed, doing normal, comfortable, relaxed breathing, slowly shift your awareness towards your palms, your hand. Try to put your mind towards the focus of your fingertips, your digits, your palm, the dorsal surface, the palmar surface of the palm, your wrist joint, putting your awareness on the area of your hand. At the back of your mind, you are visualizing that you are making this hand as loose, as comfortable, as relaxed as possible. So let us repeat something at the back of your mind, focusing your attention on your hands. My hands are becoming heavier and relaxed. My hands are becoming heavier and relaxed. My hands are becoming heavier and deeply relaxed. All the fingers, the palm, the wrist are deeply relaxed. All the muscles of your hand are relaxed. Very slowly, this relaxation wave is passing from the hand and it is moving towards the forearm. You visualize with your power of imagination, with your intuition and the intelligence of past life experiences you have seen. you visualize that a wave of relaxation, like a wave, is passing from the wrist towards the forearm. Now visualize that my forearms, both the sides, looks heavier. All the muscles of the forearms are relaxed, and I feel at complete ease with myself. Breathing is comfortable as such, automatic, autonomic. You already relaxed your hand and wrist. And now you feel the wave of relaxation passing from the wrist towards the forearm, relaxing all the muscles of your flexor compartment of your forearm and the extensor compartment of your forearm. All my forearm muscles are heavier and they are relaxed. All my forearm muscles are heavier and are relaxed. All my forearm muscles are heavier and relaxed. I let go of any tension, any spasm of the muscles at the level of your forearm. Very slowly, this wave of relaxation is passing upwards, moving upwards towards elbow, arms, and the shoulders. You're feeling that your elbows are relaxed and feel heavy. Because of this heaviness, you can feel the weight of your elbow, your arm, your shoulder, either onto the surface of the chair or onto the surface of your bed, if you're lying down. My arms, my deltoid, my triceps, biceps, brachioradialis, all the muscles of my arms are relaxed. My shoulders are relaxed. My entire upper extremity is relaxed. Very slowly, shift your attention towards your neck and the head area. If you can, relax your neck at the back of your chair, if there is a resting area. If not, you can simply hold in a most comfortable, relaxed position. Very slowly, visualize and feel that your neck muscles are relaxed. Very slowly and gently, shift your awareness towards your head. Visualize all the head muscles are relaxed. your number of thoughts are reducing from your head, from the brain. And you feel at ease with your body right now. Very slowly, shift your awareness towards your chest area. Feel at the back of your mind that your breathing is comfortable, your heartbeat is relaxed. There is a beautiful synchrony between your lungs and the heart to maintain the good oxygen, to maintain all the oxygen supply to each and every cell of your body. Optimal blood supply, comfortable. When people are under stress, few areas, few organs of your body will not get sufficient blood supply. But when you really relax deeply, in this relaxation, the blood supply to the different areas, different organs of your body will be very optimum. And body goes for something called as repair mechanism or rejuvenation process. Because it is not under stress, body focuses its resources either to build the process of repair or to heal the repairing issues. So this is the beauty of body. When body goes for deeper relaxation, it will definitely repair itself. So imagine wherever in your body there is an optimal blood supply right now, and it is repairing itself as much as possible. Very slowly and gently shift your awareness towards your abdomen. Your abdomen feels comfortable, relaxed. Your abdomen feels comfortable and relaxed. Your all internal organs of your abdomen, on your stomach, liver, pancreas, small intestine, large intestine, at the back, omentum, kidneys, every part of your stomach area are relaxed. The stomach muscles feel relaxed. The internal organs will relax by having sufficient blood supply to their internal organs. That is a relaxation for those internal organs, because they don't have a skeletal muscle like your abdomen. They have a smooth muscle. So at the back of your mind, please visualize that if somebody is having any elements of symptoms of gastritis, constipation, or any symptoms related with stomach, you just simply imagine that there is a redistribution of blood to the internal organs. And with this redistribution of blood, there is a bit of healing or repairing happening. So very, very slowly, this wave of relaxation is passing down towards the waist area, hip area, the thighs, quadriceps, hamstrings, all the veins, arteries, nerves, and all this area are feeling that relaxation response where you're training those voluntary skeletal muscles to relax autogenically and to add a visualization that you can feel the relaxation and you can make those relaxation come true in a real sense by simply visualizing it, repeating the auto suggestion, autogenic command at the back of your mind, and the body follows it. This is the beauty of epigenetics or the deeper aspect of neuro-linguistic programming, cognitive reframing, cognitive behavioral therapies, psychotherapies, spiritual healing, whatever you call, hypnotherapy. It is to unlock the hidden potentials of the subconscious mind by consciously telling that subconscious mind to relax and go deep. The mind, when it goes to the deeper levels of silence, it will explore the hidden, deeper repair mechanisms of the body. We hardly give any time for us to relax. We want the pill to reduce our blood pressure, but we don't try to reduce our blood pressure by the relaxation technique. Possible. We are not saying that replace the medicine by relaxation. We are not saying that. We only say that add a relaxation technique to focus and reduce your number of thoughts, reduce your sympathetic overactivity, and by that, for sure, the body's blood pressure will be regulated with little bit of medication, of course, if needed. So very slowly and gently move the wave of relaxation towards your knees, towards the calf muscles, towards your kneecap, towards your ankles, your toes. Visualize and feel that your entire legs are relaxed, your all calf muscles, hamstrings are relaxed, your all the skeletal muscles. Remember, there are estimated 450 to 650. Different researchers come up with different numbers. Some say 450, some say 495, some say 650 skeletal muscles. So now we visualize that all the skeletal muscles are relaxed. Now, at this juncture, visualize your entire body is deeply relaxed. Your number of thoughts are reduced. Your body is vibrating with the healing frequencies from the depth of your mind in attachment with your nervous system, which is regulating the body automatically in line with cosmic intelligence or universal intelligence. You are tapping that level of relaxation energy right now. And now, At this point of relaxation, each individual have his or her own individual stories of pain, pressure, disease, or whatever we have. Somebody have knee pain, somebody have back pain, somebody have stomach related issues, somebody have constipation, somebody have diabetes, hypertension, prostatic related problems, anything, no worries. So at this juncture of relaxation, you divert, put your mind towards the organ which is involved in that particular disease. If, for example, if it is a hypertension, most of elderly people, we have hypertension, you focus your awareness onto the heart and blood vessel and visualize your heart something normal blood pressure and feel that your arteries still are elastic. There is a less amount of atherosclerosis or less amount of hardening, and you feel that, just visualize that 20 to 40 millimeter of mercury blood pressure can be reduced by relaxation. That's very much possible. This is a part of NLP training or cognitive restructuring towards the focus disease. So gently visualize that if it is a diabetes, imagine that your blood sugar is getting normalized because you are stimulating parasympathetic nervous system. Like this, each individual with his or her own problems, focus your attention on that area or that organ of your body. If it is a low back, focus on the low back. Visualize at the back of your mind that my body is vibrating with a deeper healing frequency and it is going to get repaired by healing chemicals secreted by my body biochemistry or neurobiochemistry. The nervous system, when it secretes endorphins, my body pain feels reduced. So the biochemical changes happening, the body goes for more alkaline nature, body taps the healing frequencies, and body tries to auto-regulate. Imagine this auto-regulation is happening with you right now. So choose one sankalpa, one auto-suggestion saying that pertaining to that particular area, if it is a diabetes, say at the back of your mind that my blood sugars are becoming normalized because I'm deeply relaxed. Something like this, small positive statement for yourself and for your subconscious mind. Repeat this statement 5 times at the back of your mind. Visualize yourself from 10 years younger time when the disease was not very progressive or when you did not have any disease as such. There is a research conducted in an old age home where they changed all the furniture, all the music, all the surroundings to 40 years older times. All the olden songs, when these old people were young, during that time, what are the songs, all what are the romantic songs, what are the, you know, motivational songs, patriotic songs, whatever it is to be there during those people who were younger, those things were replaced. And they found that the agility of the people were increased, the relaxation was much better, depressions and other issues were much lesser, sleep qualities were much better, disease control was much better. I'll try to find out the exact research where it has happened, and then I'll share it with you. This message I told only for the logical mind, which will be always wanting to gather all the valid information all the time. So with this, you shift the mind and tell your mind that this is possible to reverse. It is possible to reorient. This is possible to reverse the disease, at least to control the disease with a little bit of medication, with the possibilities of relaxation techniques with auto suggestions designed particularly for your disease. Possible. Mind has tremendous capacity. It is possible. With this affirmation, very slowly and very gently, you're coming back to your body consciousness. Comfortable breathing. You're coming back to the place where your physical body is lying down, relaxing or resting on the chair. You're becoming alert and awake. You're coming back to your consciousness. You're getting completely alert and awake. Notice or the scan your body from the internal eye that your entire body seems to be deeply relaxed. Very slowly, and gently come back to full alertness. You're completely aware, completely awake. You're getting ready to open your eyes slowly to the new world of relaxed awareness. To the new world of relaxed response. To the new world of parasympathetic dominance, to the new world of equilibrium and balance of the mind and the body, through the breathing, through the auto-suggestion, through the autogenic training, through the biorhythm training. Or whatever is the process happened, don't worry, but what effects it is going to induce in you is much profound, much deeper, much beneficial. With this awareness, very, very slowly and gently, open your eyes completely. Both hands in front of your chest, rub your hands towards each other. Massage onto your forehead, cheek, chin, front of your ears, back of your ear, neck muscles. And now, with the same slow, relaxed pace, open your eyes to the new world of this relaxation. Give a pause for 30 to 40 seconds and explore and look around how you feel, how you look around. You see different colors, but now you see those colors more brighter, more communicating, because your awareness is enhanced. When your awareness is enhanced, you will be able to sense the same thing much more deeply than normal wakeful state. Okay? Some outside sound which might have disturbed you, but it is okay. So come back to complete consciousness. Be alert. And now you're free to ask any question. This is only one phase of relaxation where we designed using autogenic training, biofeedback and visualization, and also there is some part of breathing. If we connect some machine to the forearms or other part of the body, we call it as either galvanic skin resistance meter or body metabolic analyzer machine. If you connect a machine to this, the machine can show you that the body is really relaxed. The muscles are really relaxed. The circulation of this area is actually enhanced. You can feel that. So you can do the changes in the hemodynamic circulation. Hemo means blood. Dynamism is the way heart beats, the way the blood pump carries the blood towards the body. You can do the changes in this positive way. And these changes will help you to actually reorient your body or bring the body back to the normal phase of the synchronized body breath, body mind spirit alignment. In this, so this, if for example, if our body, mind and spirit are in alignment, we call it as swastha. The Sanskrit word of healthy is swastha. Swa means the self, the true self. Astha is the one who is established in the true self, swastha. So it means the person who is centered in his spirit, and with this spirit he is looking at the body and the mind, and then interacting with the outwardly world with the five senses. So that is actually very profound, very deep. It includes all the integrative medicine, all the mind-body medicine, all the spiritual practices. Everything is designed to make you centralized, or make you centered at your true self, not the false self. So by that, swastha is the one who is centered in his true self. True self is very original, no faking, very real. So true self, centered self, body and mind and five senses. That would be more comfortable and more easy for interacting with the world.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. I have one question. This is PM. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This is, you started with the paw, then you went to the head, and then you went to the feet, right?
Yeah.
But can I start with the feet? Yeah.
Very good question. We started like this, but can start from the head and come back to the, start from the head, neck, then shoulders, then arms. You can come like that. Or I can start from the toes and come upwards. No problem.
Okay.
No problem.
Okay.
Usually, different techniques, like all these techniques I connect with Yoga Nidra.
Okay.
Yoga Nidra or the next class, what we do is the JPMR. I usually start like this. I also start with the palms, or you can start with the toes. No problem. It is all your convenience that matters. So it is no hard and fast rule that you have to start from hands only. You can start. See, for example, if somebody is having, take an example, if somebody is having head pain, I'll start with the head first. If somebody is having back pain, I'll focus exclusively on the back. Then visualize the back area. Imagine like, your question is very good. Draw something.
Yeah.
I'll draw some small picture here. Imagine this is your back. Okay.
Yeah.
So I imagine a red ball. I imagine a red ball at the lower back area. I feel this as a pain area, and imagine that this red ball is becoming smaller and smaller. It will become dispersed, and very slowly body is absorbing all this red spot into my lower back, and all the pain is getting diffused or healed. So that is my visualization for lower back. I modify like that. So you, everybody imagines, you know, light at the pain area. If it is shoulder pain, you imagine there is a light here, red light spot. So in this pain area, pain spot is slowly getting diffused. So it is slowly getting dimmer, dimmer, lighter, dimmer, dimmer, and lighter, lighter, and slowly it is disappearing. Like that, I create a visualization. So no restriction in this field of relaxation, where you use your intelligence, use your intuition. At the same time, you are free to imagine anything. So I imagine like a bulb and diffusion of that light as a pain reduction method. We call it as analgesic hypnotherapy. So you make the pain relieving hypnotherapy with visualization. Like this.
Thank you, Dr.
Yeah. Yes.
Doctor, last time you said for yoga nidra, whatever that instructions are, narration you are giving, there is a audio with you. Just you wanted to share.
Ah, yes, sir. I'll share with Rajesh, sir. I think, see, if at all you need, I have around they're not very good quality videos, but I have very quality few audios on my YouTube channel. If you type my name, you'll get all those, sir. But I'll share something with Rajesh, sir, where he can share it with you.
Right. Already I asked him, but still I have not received anything of that.
Okay. So, yeah, I think what I'll do is, see, it's very simple. It is not very new for me to teach relaxation. Almost 10, 12 years I'm doing the same. And if you type my name, you can type like see, like DRSHASHIKANT and SK.
One minute. This is where I have to type. This is?
Type it in Google. Sir. Google or YouTube will get all this.
YouTube.
Yeah, just YouTube. One word. Yes, sir. One word you can type DRSHASHIKANT.
Shashikant
SK. If you type this, you get all my videos.
All small letters.
Or if you can type Unmukt Senior Hub, there are the three techniques what we have, relaxation technique we have done. It is there.
Okay.
So the code word is Unmukt Senior Hub. Also, you can type. You can type Dr. Shashikant also, you'll get it.
Okay. Right. So
I
uploaded
like that. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Let me check. In case there is any problem, I'll come back to you.
Yes, sir. No problem.
Very refreshing session, Dr. Shashikant.
Yes, ma'am. You should.
Simple technique. Huh?
Yes, these things can be added in a day-to-day basis. For example, before you sleep, actually this refreshes. And if we are not able to do it on our own, we can share those audios. Which once we have already done, it will be easy for us to do the follow-up. So some audios I'll share it with the team. I think they'll share it with you.
Doctor, you just now said that this relaxation technique, we have to do it before we sleep, correct?
Anytime.
When can we do this?
Anytime. Actually, anytime. Whenever you have time, you can do this. But if somebody is more stressed up or somebody is not getting sleep, they can do this more little extended one, like 40 minutes. Normally, if you have time, you can just visualize. Imagine there is some area of the part of your body is paining. You can just simply focus your attention on that area. Imagine that muscles are getting relaxed. Repeat that relaxation for 5 times, and you can really feel that muscles are really relaxing. So why? Because your number of thoughts are reducing, and body the nervous system focuses on the parasympathetic nervous system. When parasympathetic nervous system, muscles will get relaxed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, sir.
So, Dr. Shashikant, we are done for the day today?
Hi, sir.
Okay, so can I take a few minutes, remaining few minutes, and talk to the
No problem, sir.
Yes? Okay.
No problem. No problem.
Okay. So, see, first of all, I have a bad news to share with all of you. Everybody knows Dr. Meenal Rajni, who has been conducting our wall yoga sessions and chair yoga sessions. She lost her mother-in-law day four yesterday, and her mother-in-law's marka is today. But tomorrow also, she is unable to conduct our session, you know, the wall yoga session that is scheduled for 4 o'clock tomorrow. She will not be able to conduct that. So our apologies for that. And day after tomorrow, being Ram Navami, is a holiday. And we had deliberately not, you know, planned anything for 21st of April because we wanted everyone to celebrate. So Meenal will be back with us on 22nd afternoon with a regular session on chair yoga. So that's what I thought I'll share with everyone. We'll obviously be sharing it on email also. Just in case, if there is anybody who is interested in attending the online marka of our mother-in-law today, which is at 5:30, so he or she can let me know. I'll share the link with him or her. So that's all from my side. If you have any questions to ask about anything, remaining few minutes, you know, we can utilize for that. If you have any questions for me or any suggestions or comments about our programs, please do feel free to share with me.
Sir, I'll attend that ceremony.
Okay. Can I just have your name? Vijay Lakshmi.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll have it emailed to you, ma'am. If there's anybody else who is interested, please let me know. I'll share the link for the marka ceremony.
Yes, send it to me too.
Okay, sure, sir. Sure, Mr. Gupta.
Put it in the WhatsApp group only. We can also.
Pardon, sir?
Put it in the WhatsApp group also.
Okay. I'll do that.
That is easy. Everybody will look into it.
Yes. We can do that. No worries at all. So, thanks a lot, Dr. Shashikant, once again. And we look forward to you hosting the second part of today's workshop on 23rd. And that's it, sir. I mean, thanks a lot for being with us. You have been very regular, and your sessions are highly appreciated by each and every one of our members. There are no words that, you know, I have to express my gratitude for your sessions, but they are very, very appreciated, and we really appreciate our association. The links that you talked about, if you could share those links with me in a document or in any form, I'll make sure that they are sent to all our members. So that's it, everybody. We are wrapping up a few minutes earlier today. We hope to see you again on Thursday, 4 o'clock, chair yoga session with Meenal.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.